that is the fact that God is aware of you. He knows exactly what you have need of. But he says, knock, seek, or ask, seek, and knock, and you'll find. Amen? You gotta tell him what you want. Amen. Amen. Well, praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Father, we thank you again, God, for just this day. We thank you, Lord, for the anointing that's been released in this house. We thank you, Lord, for the salvation of the souls around these altars. Thank you for the anointing that's dropped, Lord God, on our special singing today, God, and touched our hearts. And God, you're getting our attention for the purpose, God, of looking up and seeing you. Lord, as we come into the house of God, we realize that when we lift our eyes up higher, we find the purpose of our life, that is to find Jesus Christ. Even the prophet said that he was in the temple, and he saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple, meaning his presence filled the house of God. And the presence of the Lord fills the house of God when people will praise him. God himself said, I will dwell among the praises of my people. And with a heart to find the face and the heart of God, we will find him. We will find him when we seek him with all of our heart. And he's here in this place. And he's here because you're here. Amen. You are important to God. He knows you before you're even formed in the womb of your mother. The Lord knows you. And he has a plan for your life. We've been preaching for the last couple of weeks, last few weeks, on a thought of having our minds changed, being transformed. The title or the theme of the church has been, what is the church thinking? And we've taken the theme from Romans 12, 1 and 2, very familiar passage of the scripture there, Romans 12, 1 and 2. I want to read them real quick. I'm not going to preach today. Just I don't have enough time to preach what the Lord has given me. I'm going to give you something before you leave today. Amen. You need to take something with you today. Amen. You need to take something. You need to have an impartation by the Spirit of God through his word today that you can grab a hold on to. Amen. You need the word of God. Something to touch your soul today that you can take home with you. But in Romans 12, the Apostle Paul is writing to the church at Rome. Christians have been born again, just like several have been born again here today. Aren't you glad that you were born again? We are carriers of eternal life. Praise the Lord. Eternal life is flowing through us. Does that mean I'm not going to die? Maybe. Depends on God's time schedule. But if I die, amen, it's just a vehicle of opening up me into a new existence, and I'm going to find heaven is real. I'm going to find out that Jesus Christ is the keeper of his word. I'm going to find out that God's ultimate plan of eternity for me is going to come to fruition. Amen. It's a wonderful thing to be born again. It's a wonderful thing to know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And we have some young people, amen, today that got touched by the power of God. Young lady right here, give her heart to the Lord. I can just see the Holy Spirit moving in your soul today. Amen. Amen. Young lady, you're going to give your heart to God for the first time. The Lord moves into your heart today. Praise the Lord. God bless you. And you've got to write this day down in your memory. Write this day down, amen, somewhere. Remember this day. It becomes the most important day of your life when you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. So on July 17, 2016, your name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life, and you were born again. Amen. Amen. You and Jesus now, amen, are walking in a personal relationship. And this is what Paul is addressing to the church of Rome, and they were born again Christians. They had accepted the message of the gospel. The word gospel simply means good news. The good news is that Jesus loves you and died for your sins. The good news, amen, is that death couldn't hold him to the ground. The good news is that once we're saved, praise the Lord, all things become new. How many knows what I'm talking about today? Are you saved today? Are you born again today? Amen. Amen. And so it's an important thing to grab a hold of and treasure. Amen. It's treasure hidden in earthen vessels. That we are saved, that we have eternal life in our soul. And so Paul is addressing to the church at Rome because these believers in Rome, they're born again. They're newborn Christians. The Bible says that we are like newborn babies when we're born again. It's, He'll take that spiritual truth and bring it a natural application, or vice versa. We take a natural truth and bring a spiritual application. When you receive Jesus Christ as your Savior, you are born again. You are brand new. Amen. Amen. You don't even look the same. That's the truth. You want to get better, look and get saved. Now, I can't prove that by scripture. But I do know this, amen, that I was ugly before I got saved. Amen. I had the license of before and after for a while. You guys wouldn't believe what I looked like before. You think I'm hard to look at now, you should have seen me before. You've got to thank God right now, amen, that your pastor got saved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But it's a wonderful thing, it really is, to be saved and be born again, to have the earthen treasure, praise God, the eternal treasure in this earthen body, amen, of eternal life. It's an incredibly important and true experience with God. And I just want to continue to remind the congregation today that feeling the presence of the Lord is important to understand and recognize and appreciate. Because the presence of God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, as the psalm singer was saying, amen, it's the same person, Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, same thing. Spirit means ghost, ghost means spirit, just depends on how dignified or undignified you want to sound, I guess. Doesn't matter to me, I say Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit, after what it is. I call it whatever, you know, Spirit of God, Spirit of truth, Spirit of grace, amen, just be here. Because I don't want to go home without it, amen, how about you? But he does, he comes among the praises of his people, he comes into his church because he wants to bless you, and when you feel the blessings of God, sometimes you just can't really stand it. I mean, yeah, you can stand it, but it's almost like you watch people getting filled with the Spirit of God and or getting overwhelmed with the Spirit of God. It's almost comical. It's kind of funny. It's like they start cringing. They start going, like God's trying to kill them or something, you know. They can't like take the glory of God. Amen. Some of them, the Holy Spirit comes on some people so hard, they just fall over. You ever see that? Stay with us. You will. Amen. And it's the glory of God, and we want more of the glory, because when we get into the glory of God, we get more like Jesus. Yes. Amen. I'm taking my text yet, how about you? There you go, Pastor. There you go again, starting to meddle and mingle and all this stuff before you even take a text. The glory of God brings us into a place of being more like Jesus. The scripture says that we are changed and made like Him from glory to glory. So we want to come into the center of the glory, the presence of the Holy Spirit. It's the vital, most important thing of a church service, knowing that we have come into the presence of the Lord. Amen. And feeling the glory fall on us because He's doing something in us when He falls on us. So this church in Rome, they were really excited. They were new. They were fresh. They were just kind of like a pioneer church. They're growing by leaps and bounds. They're testifying about the good things that God does, because once He saves you, He begins to use your life in whatever measure you can be used. From the day you get saved, you have a testimony in your life. Amen. You really do. It's like, man, you just don't know what I felt like. You don't know, amen, what the Lord has done for me. You don't know, like I know, what the Lord has done for me. Amen. Amen. And you got a testimony, and when it's real, amen, no one can talk you out of it. Because you know God did something. You might not be able to fully explain it, but you know. It's that place where you know that you know. You know? So this is this church. He's addressing them, and he's telling them this. He said, I'm begging you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. So some instruction is coming down now. He's beginning to tell them how to begin to anchor themselves in Jesus. Amen. We've got to be anchored in Jesus. Because trials and adversity are going to come by all of our way. We're going to have challenges in life. Things are going to happen that are not good to the people of God, because it rains on the just and the unjust. And we've got to be ready. We've got to be anchored. We've got to be secure in our faith and who we know that God is able. How many know that God is able? Yeah. Hallelujah. More than that, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we even ask for then. Amen. So when we say God is able, He's bigger than that. Hello, somebody. He's bigger than anything that you can believe God for. He's bigger than that. Amen. Our God is able to do exceedingly abundantly. authority above all that we ask or think. In other words, amen, you can't measure God. He's bigger than you can even believe Him for. Amen. The problem is not God being able to do things. The problem is us being able to believe that He will.
Amen.
Amen. He says, if you believe, all things are possible to those who believe. Amen. I want to believe God for big things. How about you? Amen. Amen. I don't want to settle for less than what God has in store. I don't want to settle for less than what God says we can have. I don't want to settle for anything less than what God's Word declares that we can do, because we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus who loved us.
Amen.
If somebody needs to grab a hold of that right there, you're in a battle, you're in a challenge, something's blocking your way, just let them know, get out of my way because I'm coming through in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Grab a hold of that right there. That's a good word for you today. Amen. Verse 2 says, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, that ye may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Yes.
Amen. I just want to leave you with this thought here today, that God is doing something in you. Do you feel Him moving in your life? Do you feel the operation of God happening in you? Only God, amen, can lead you somewhere, amen, and have a signed contract in the house in a day. Hello, somebody. Can you wave at me today? Glory to God. Glory to God. God knows what He is doing in your life. And not only does He know what He's doing, He's leading you when you let Him lead. And can I just clue you in on something? Let Him lead. Because God knows where He's going. Amen. God's not lost. We are. Amen. Amen. And so let Him lead. And so He says that we may prove what is a good and perfect and acceptable will of God. We want to be found right in the center of what God wants for our life. Because God knows better than we even do on what's going to be good for our life. So what do we do? Again, we come to the Lord. It says, the Bible says, present your bodies a living sacrifice. Does that mean we have to kill ourselves? No. We're a living sacrifice. We're to come and just give God our son, that God, here I am. Lead me and guide me to what you want for my life. God has a plan for you. He said that we may prove what is a good and perfect and acceptable will of God. God's will, amen, is the fact that He has a plan for your life. How many knows that God has a plan for your life?
Yeah.
What is that plan? God knows the plan. Right? God knows the plan He has for your life. He said we need to prove, we need to test, we need to find out what God's will is for our lives.
Yeah.
Amen. And that's a lifetime journey. It's a lifetime process. God knows me by name. When I was born, He had a plan for my life, and He has a plan for your life. Amen. He has a destiny, a purpose. Something good for us. Amen. And so we need to figure that out, whatever that is, and say, Lord, I'm not a very good manager of my own life. I might be good, I might be better than somebody else, but I'm not that good. Some people's lives, amen, they need to get their lives in order. Don't look around. I'm not throwing stones. I know I'm messed up. I know I need God's help. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But God's plan is perfect. And so what we do, we get to the place where we understand that we can mess things up. And we turn to God and say, Lord, I'm just going to come to you. I'm going to give you my life. I'm going to trust you to work out the situation in the matter. I'm going to listen for what you want me to do.
Amen.
I've got a whole chart of things that you need to know what to do in order to find the center of God's will. But you're going to have to come back next week. Somebody just got real excited over here because I'm getting ready to close. It's the kiss message. Yeah, only a few of you know what that means. I'm not kissing you goodbye. That means just keep it simple and short. I've got my short down. But here's God's plan for you. Listen. Here's what God says. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know, says the Lord, the plan that I have for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you, and to give you hope in the future. This is God's plan in a nutshell for your life and for my life. This is what God has declared for you guys today. He's saying, this is my plan. If you'll let me work in your life, this is what I will do to you. I will lead you into a place where you'll prosper and will not be harmed. I will lead you into a place where you'll have hope and you'll have a future. How many knows today that that's a good plan? Can I see your hands? Amen. 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 So what we do, we begin to present our bodies a living sacrifice unto God that we may move into that place. And that's the voice of God today. He's saying, come into this place of relationship with me, says the Lord. Come into this place to where you listen to what I say and just give it to me. And let me lead. Let me guide. I will take you to a place of hope. And I will take you to a place of a great future. Your destiny before the Lord is a place of hope and a place of a great future. Would you stand all around this church with me? We serve a good God. We serve a good God. He has done great and mighty things here today. Amen. His glory has been spread out across this church. Souls have been saved. You've connected to the Spirit of God today. You may not advance forward to this altar, but your heart was touched by the Lord this morning. You were blessed, and you're leaving here blessed today. You were blessed to get here, but you're more blessed, amen, as you're leaving here. Amen. Amen. God has made you more blessed because He's touched you by His amazing grace. Hallelujah. Would you lift your hands all around the church with me?